Good. Me and my old friend the Wind is here to show you one more video, just to create one more video about systems of linear equations. I really want to finish with systems of linear equations. They are really not that important in the greater scheme of things or solving them with these row operations. It's not what linear algebra is about. The matrices that we're going to look at and what they represent, what you can do with them, the abstract notion of a matrix, that's what it's all about. But let's do one more. Just so you get to fully understand what these row operations are all about. Once again, I'm going to create my own three equations and three unknowns. I'm going to decide x is 1, y is 2, and z is 1. And I'm just going to represent them there. There's my x values, 1, 1, 1. My y values, 2, 2, 2. My z values, 1, 1, 1. And I've just put arbitrary constants in front of them. A 1, a 2, and a 1. A 1, a 1, a 2. A 3, and a 1, and 1. So 1 times 1 is 1, 1 times 2 is 2, 3 times 1 is 1, 1 plus 2 plus 3 is 6, 2 plus 2 plus 1 is 5, 1 plus 4 plus 1 is 6. So what we actually have is the following. We're going to have x plus y plus 3z equals 6, and we're going to have 2x plus y plus z equals 5. And then here we're going to have an x plus a 2y plus z also equals 6. Three equations and three unknowns. I've created them myself. I know what the solutions are because I created them. Remember, you might not get it in this format. You might get this expressed as z itself. So for instance, here you will have z equals minus 2x minus y plus 5. And you just have to bring all the x, y, z's or x sub 1's, x sub 2, x sub 3, whatever the case may be, over to the left-hand side to do this. And from here, we can create our augmented matrix. And the augmented matrix is just going to be these coefficients, remember? So that's 1, 1, 3, and 6. And we're going to have 2 and 1 and 1 and 5. And we're going to have 1 and 2 and 1 and 6. You can put that there if you want to, if you have to. And there's our augmented matrix. So let's do the row operations, but what I want to do is I want to go step by step, so this is going to be a bit of a stuttering lecture because I'm going to clean the board every time. We'll solve this algebraically and the representation in the matrix form, just so that you fully understand what these row operations are all about instead of just trying to memorize them. Okay, so here we go. We've got our system of linear equations on this side, and it's represented as a matrix, an augmented matrix on this side. And we're just trying to solve this. All I want you to know, of course, that these are equations. This equals that. So if I added 6 to this side and 6 to this side for this middle one, same thing, I've added 6 to both sides. But I can add 6 to this side and all of this to that side. Same thing, because these two things here are equal. So what I do to the other one, I do to the other one. So the first row operation that you might have been taught is just to change the rows, just to interchange the rows. So one of the common tricks is just to put the one with the largest coefficient at the top. So we can go for 2x plus y plus z equals 5, and then that's the first one. Then we'll put that one, x plus y plus 3z equals 6. And then we're going to have x plus 2y plus z equals 6. So for my augmented matrix here, I'm not going to put the dashes and these. Let's just stick to the numbers, the coefficients 2, 1, 1, 5. And then I'm going to have 1, 1, 3, and 6. And then I'm going to have 1, 2, 1, and 6. So just interchange the rows. That's all I'm doing. I'm just writing one equation ahead of the other one. Now, if I notice, I can do something here. I can multiply. My idea here is to get rid of the x and get rid of the y, so I'm just left with a z, and then to work backwards. So if I notice that if I multiply this second one throughout by negative 2, I get negative 2x, I get negative 2y, I get negative 6, z, and I get negative 12. And I can do the same thing with the second one, because I can get negative 2x, I can get negative 4z, I can get negative 2z, and I can get negative 12. So if I do that, the same thing here, I get 2, 1, 1, that stays the same. So this becomes negative 2 that's negative 2, that's negative 6, that's negative 12, and the same here, negative 2, negative 4, negative 2, negative 12. Because what I can do now is just to do the following. I want to add something to this side of the equation, this first one. And if I do something to the left-hand side, I've got to do something to the right-hand side as well. So this is what I did on this side. I multiplied this side by negative 2 and that side by negative 2. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to be clever about it. I'm going to add this to this side of the equation and that one to that side of the equation. But that equals that. So I'm adding the same thing to both sides. So the first one is still going to stay the same, 2x plus y plus z equals 5. And now let's add, if I were to add this and this together, the x's, the y's, and the z's go together. So that gives me a 0x, so x is gone, which is what I want. This is going to be a negative y, it's going to be left. This is going to be negative 5, negative 5z, and that's going to be a negative 7. Is that right? Minus 12 plus 5, that's negative 7. And I'm going to do the same here. That's 0x. It's exactly what I want. This is a negative 3y. And with z, I've got left a negative z. Is that right? Z and a minus 2z. And here, I've also got left a negative 7. So let's just see on the augmented matrix side. I'm going to have 2, 1, 1, 5. That gives me 0. And I can do that, and I stay in the columns. And you can see why we stay in the columns there. That's going to be a negative 1. This is going to be a negative 5. That's going to be a negative 7. And the same here, 2 and a negative 2. If I were to add this to this and that to that, which is what we're doing there, I still get a 0 there. Get a minus 3 here. Get a minus 1 there. And I get a minus 7 there. At least we are this far that we've gotten rid of these two leading zeros. What about getting rid of the 3 here? So I have a 0 and a 0 so that there's nothing there. Well, if I have negative 3y, what I can do is multiply this one throughout by negative 3. 0 times negative 3 is still 0. Negative 3 times that, that's going to give me a positive 3. That's going to give me a positive 15. And that's going to give me a positive 21. Now I have that, and I can do the same here. If I multiply that by negative 3, I get 3. That by negative 3, I get 15. That by negative 3, I get 21. So let's add this left-hand side to this left-hand side, that right-hand side to that right-hand side. So I'm still going to be left with 2x plus y plus z equals 5. And same here, I'm left with a 0x plus 3y plus 15z equals 21. Now let's add this. I'm still left with a 0x. Now I'm left with a 0y. That's fantastic. And I'm left with 14 z's. And I'm left with 14 on that end, that as well. And immediately I can see if I divide this side by 14 and that side by 14, I get z equals 1. And that's exactly what I'm going to see here. I'm going to be left with 2, 1, 1, 5. I'm going to be left with 0, 3, 15, and 21. And I'm left with 0, a 0, a 14, and a 14. And if I say, if I were to do that, I'm left with 15 and 15. 1 and 1. 1 and 1. So I already know that z equals 1. I've done that. I can do that here. I'm just going to have plus z equals 1. So I already know what z equals 1 is. Now we just want to move 1 up. And above this z, I want all zeros as well. So I notice that if I multiply this one throughout by negative 15z, negative 15z, that's going to be 0x, 0y, minus 15z equals minus 15. So I can multiply throughout, and I get minus 15, minus 15. Let's clear this, and then I can start working from there. From the top again, so you can see 1, 2, 3, so it's that line. So you see in tandem what is happening here. So I'm still left with that 2x plus y plus z equals 5, and if I add this left hand side to that and this right hand side to that, I'm still left with a 0x, I'm still left with 3y's, and I'm left with 0z's, and that's going to equal 7. Is that 6? And I'm left with 6, and in this side I still have 0x plus 0y plus z equals 1. Just divide by 15 on both sides. So I'm getting 2, 1, 1, 5. I'm getting 0, 3, 15, and 21. Well, I'm adding 0 and 0. So that's a 0, and that's a 6. And I'm still left with 0, 0, 1, 1. So all I have to do is try and get rid of this z here. And let's clean the board. Okay, board is cleaned. Let's carry on. So what I can do is I can multiply throughout by negative 1 here. So that's going to give me a negative z and a negative 1. So I'm going to have a negative and a negative. And I can add this left-hand side to that and this left-hand side to that. What am I going to get? 0x and 2x. Is this 2x still? 0y and y is still a y. Minus z and positive z, that gives me a 0z. And that equals negative 1 to that is 4. And I still have 0x and I have 3y's and I have 0z's and I have a 6. And on this side, still 0x plus 0y plus 1z, or just the z equals 1. So if I were to do this, that's 2, 1, 0, 4. If I add this last one to this first one, this is still 3, 0, 0, 3, 0, 6, and 0, 0, 1, 1. And all I have to try to still have to do is just to get rid of this one here so that I have just that single one. What I do notice here is that if I multiply divide by 3 throughout, 3 divided by 3 is 1, and that 6 divided by 3 is 2, and immediately I can see what is happening here. If I multiply and divide by 3 throughout, 0 divided by 3, 3 divided by 3, 0 divided by 3, 6 divided by 3 is 2. So I can immediately see that y equals 2. I've already had z equals 1. And all I have to do is multiply throughout by negative 1 here and negative 1 here so that I can add this left-hand side to that and lift this left-hand side to that. So if I were to do that, that's minus 1, minus 1, minus 2. And if I were to add this to that, I get a 2x, I get a 0y, I get a 0z, and I get a 2. And yeah, I still have 0x plus y plus 0z equals, and multiply again by negative 1 throughout, that just gives me the positive 2 again, and here I have 0x plus 0y plus z equals 1. And on this side, I've done my negative still here. If I just add this to that and this side to that side, I'm going to get 2, 0, 0, 2. And if I multiply by minus 1, I get 0, 1, 0, 2, 0, 0, 1, 1. And all I have to do is here divide by 2 throughout, which means I get a 1 and a 1. If I multiply by a half or divide by 2, multiply by a half throughout, a half times 2, that's just equals 1. That's still a 0, that's still a 0, and that becomes a 1. And that's what we have now. We have x plus nothing is 1, so x is 1. Y is 2 and z is 1. And we have it on this side as well. 1, x there is 1, y is 2, and z is 1, just as we did before. So you can see that these elementary row operations is nothing but just leaving out the x, y's, and z's and sticking columns to columns. But later on you'll see that you can interchange columns as well. You know, you can go get into all of that. But as long as you understand the concept of what happening here, it's just algebra, and I'm just leaving out the variables to get it on this side. And what I do to the left-hand side, I do to the right-hand side. But because these two things are equal, if I add this to that, then I add this to that, I have not changed this equation. Because these two things, this thing and this thing, is the same. So if I were to add this to that and I add this to that, that's the exact same thing. And it's nice that we write these in columns. so that I don't have to write out this whole long thing, this thing plus that thing. I can just stick column to column, so the x's, the y's, and the z's stay the same, and it's just simple algebra. So there you go, linear equations done and dusted. What I'll show you just very quickly in Mathematica, let's just check that what we had, you know, was indeed absolutely correct. We can just do the row reduce there and draw our little planes just to get some exercise. So make these for yourself and solve them. Just a bit of exercise. I think it's pointless, but well, there you go. Okay, so here we are in Mathematica. We see the three equations that we had. X plus Y plus 3Z is 6. 2X plus Y plus Z is 5. And X plus 2Y plus Z equals 6. You can see the cell here. I've done one of those numbered equations. Just want to show you how it would look like. Perhaps in your exams, you'll get them all expressed as a function of Z. So Z equals minus a third X minus a third Y plus 2. So I've just isolated Z there on the left-hand side. And the same for the second two equations. It helps if you have it in this format, because if we do go into plotting these, you know, we're going to need it in that format. And then here we have the augmented equation. Let's just do that plot 3D. Let's just do the plot 3D. And we're going to put, as always, the square brackets. And then in parentheses, we're going to do these three equations here in Z. So I'm going to have minus 1 over, and that is control or command and the forward slash to get 3. I'm going to use my arrow key to go to the right, so I have my negative third there, and I must say multiply by x. I could also just say space x. There's got to be that space, and then minus another one over 3, arrow to the right, space y plus 2, comma, let's go for the second one. I have minus 2 space x minus y plus 5. And the last one I'm going to have is a minus x minus 2 space y, to indicate 2 times y, plus 6. I'm going to close my curly brace. It's my list of three equations. And I've just got to tell Mathematica what I want these domains for x and y to be. So I'm going to say x goes from, let's make it negative 5 to 5. That's a safe bet usually with these. Let's take y from negative 5 to 5 as well. And let's just plot that. And there we can see beautifully. Let me increase the size of this. And we can see the point in which these three planes intersect. And that is indeed x equals 1, y is 2, and z equals 1. Let's create an augmented matrix here. I'm going to call it A. And I'm going to put each row inside of its own set of square curly braces, I should say, and that was 1 comma 1 comma 3 comma 6. Close my curly brace, comma, my next row is 2 comma 1 comma 1 comma 5 comma 5. There we go. And the last one was 1 comma 2 comma 1 comma 6. Close that line, close the whole thing, and shift enter or shift return, and there I have. And if I wanted to see that in matrix form, I can say matrix, and I'm going to tab down to get to form, matrix form of A, and I see the augmented matrix there. Remember, I could also do postfix notation, so A forward slash matrix form, matrix form, and there we go, exactly the same thing. Let's do the row reduction on this, row reduce, and I'm going to pass A. And I'm just going to express this in matrix form as well. And that's our row reduced form. And I see x equals 1, y equals 2, and z equals 1. As simple as that. So that's it. Elementary row operations, row reduced form, Gauss-Jordan elimination, systems of linear equations done. Let's concentrate a bit on the matrices that we get from these themselves. See them as something that exists on their own and not necessarily part of a system of linear equations. I hope you get the systems of linear equations. I hope you get these row operations done and dusted. Let's move on.